If you are anything like me, you need your carp fishing fix on a weekly basis. And that means going regardless of weather, conditions, anything like that, winter, spring, summer or autumn. As we are now in the winter, doesn't change. I probably get a night a week, luckily, and that doesn't change through the winter season. As a result, through my experience, I've picked up a few tips and tricks that will definitely put a few more fish on the bank during the colder months, and I'm going to share them with you now. So, tip one, fish the right venue. In fact, I'm going to give you two in one here, two for the price of one. Venue and location. Venue is massive. There is, yeah, all due respect to the guys that fish the massive inland seas, hundreds of acres with a handful of carp in, but that is not conducive to catching a winter carp. I work 9 to 5 like a lot of you guys, and when you go fishing, one, you want to enjoy yourself, two, you want to catch fish. And that means fishing the right places. Fishing well-stocked venues, shallower venues will warm up quicker. Deeper venues will hold their temperature. I'll come onto that in a second tip in a moment. But make sure you fish, one, the right venue, two, the right location within that venue. Tip two then. Tip two for me, we'll look at conditions, weather conditions. If you can pick the weather conditions, the right conditions, in my opinion, then do. If you're flexible with your working pattern or your shifts or your fishing time with your family, then pick the right conditions. Last week, we had some biblical winter conditions, 10, 12 degrees during the day, not dropping much below 8, 9s at night, overcast, southwesterlies, just warm weather pushing in. And yeah, undoubtedly, Facebook, Instagram were rife with captures from a number of different venues. This week, as I'm sat here now, it's 4 degrees, it's cold, it's high pressure, not necessarily conducive to carp fishing, but still get out there if you can. So tip two for me, if you can, and you're lucky enough to be able to, pick the right conditions. Tip three, bait. Bait for me is a minefield, like I'm sure it is for a lot of you. And I don't profess to know a great deal about bait and its construction. However, through experience, I do know what bait works, or for me, works through the winter. That doesn't necessarily mean that I'm gonna put 5 kilos of 18 mil boilers in. For me, particles this time of year and small bits come into their own. They don't fill the fish up. You can use them as pre-bait. And again, that's another tip that I'll share with you shortly. And not only that, but when you are fishing, I use small amounts, just enough for a bite at a time. Especially if you've pre-baited, which I'll come onto shortly, just putting a little top up over the top of where you've been baiting. Or if you're starting new on a venue or a day ticket where you can't pre-bait or aren't lucky enough to be able to, just a handful, just a few spots, and using small amounts of bait, so not to feed the fish too much, is definitely something I'd advise. My favorites at this time of year, hemp, some monster maize, natural baits, or crushing your boilers and making small powdered type meals. Buckwheat, things like that, mixed particles, all of which you can get in jars, etc., freely available. I would look to something like that. And probably ratio wise, I would look to at least 2/3 would be particles. And then I'd look to add my bits and pieces. Finally, liquids, and that's gonna be my tip four. Utilize liquids, the solubility of them in the water in the colder months. Again, it's well versed in carp fishing literature about using oils and things and winterized versions of your liquids. Your relevant bait companies can supply you that information. But for me, liquids would be my tip number four. Lots of attraction, minimal food value, you're not gonna fill the fish up. Last but not least, tip five, if you can, pre-bait. I was very lucky enough a few years back now to be able to fish a good exclusive syndicate where I could pre-bait. And my one night a week, I was able to fish over areas where I knew fish were visiting, I could view the area, and my catches were relevant to that. I caught a lot of fish over the pre-baited areas. And undoubtedly it put more carp on my mat. There's your five tips. They will undoubtedly help you catch more fish if you utilize them through the colder months.